My day consists of a lot of stuff that's just a necessity for business, answering phones, emails, stuff like that. So anything that I can get away from that and focus on the art is what I enjoy most about it. The thing that I enjoy waking up and looking forward to is just being creative and knowing that it's my mind and my soul that I'm putting into certain projects that it's kind of like an itch you can't scratch, and the only way you can scratch it is by actually doing the work, and that's what makes me feel better and makes me feel successful, I guess. Usually when I approach a project with free rein, I usually have an idea bouncing around in my mind that's been bouncing around there for a while, and I internalize it, and then it comes out in certain ways. And when I get a project where I can actually do it on my own, I feel like I can release that onto a certain piece of art that I'm working on. I use a lot of tape in my work. It's one of those things where I view myself as a tape artist more than a custom painter, because sometimes I enjoy just looking at the stuff that I've taped rather than painting it. It kind of becomes a part of you after a while, is unrolling tape that's rolled up in a roll onto a piece of art. You know, I can lay out flames with my eyes closed. So it definitely, as a tradesman and a craftsman, your tool becomes a part of you after a while. And I think that tape definitely, for me, has become a part of me as much as a spray gun or a pinstriping brush. U.S. Chemical, USC, they have what they call a handy mask. It's a 7-inch piece of paper that already has a masking on it to where you can pull it and tear whatever you need to do per piece. So it saves you a lot of time, especially if you're doing artwork, because you don't have to tear a piece off like a paper tree or a paper dispenser to do your work. You can just do a handheld piece, then you can put it where you want, and you can actually fold it around like a curved surface, especially when I'm working on round stuff like motorcycle tanks and helmets. It really makes sense to use that because of speed, and it's already preformed, so it already has a tape on the paper, so you just pick and tear. So that makes a really handy addition to any artist's arsenal. It just adds one more thing that helps you out in the job. With me having kind of ideas of my head about what I want to do, you kind of go through a roller coaster of emotions going through a project. You start out with a little bit of anxiety, wondering what it's going to look like, where you're going to go with. And then during the project, you got ideas that you're putting on there, and sometimes you don't know exactly where it's going, but you feel it, and you know exactly that it feels right, so you keep going, kind of free flowing, and it's snowball effect where, you know, one thing goes good and another thing goes good and another thing goes good, and then finally you're done with the piece, and you look at it and you're like, wow, you know, this is what I created. Everybody played a tough guy to shoot for.